A blacksmith might take a steel rod and put it in a flame when forging metal. He can judge how hot the metal rod is by carefully watching the changing color of the steel. In chemistry lessons, you would have used Bunsen burners and noticed that you can get a blue flame from it, whereas tea candle burns with a yellowish flame. As an object gets hotter, two things happen to the light that it emits. First, it begins to emit more light at every wavelength so that it gets brighter. Second, it changes color because the peak of the emission shifts to the blue end of the spectrum. Let me explain this using a graph with wavelength on the x-axis and the intensity of the wave on the y-axis. Take a star, for example, that has a surface temperature of 4000 Kelvin. It emits radiation with all of these wavelengths, ranging from infrared to visible light to ultraviolet. But you can see that the peak intensity is around 700 nanometers in the red region of the visible light spectrum. So even though the star emits all these other wavelengths, the fact that it emits red visible light at the highest intensity will make it appear red. For a star that has a higher surface temperature, such as 7000 Kelvin, it emits more light. So the graph must be higher to show that it emits all wavelengths at a higher intensity. But if you look at it carefully, you can spot that it no longer peaks in the red region. The peak has shifted towards the left-hand side, so that the maximum intensity is now in the blue region. This star appears blue. Comparing these two stars, we begin to see a relationship between the object's temperature and the wavelength with the highest intensity. So the peak wavelength is inversely proportional to temperature. This law is known as the Wien's displacement law. The constant of proportionality between them is called Wien's constant, which is 2.898 times 10 to the power of minus 3 meters Kelvin. This law is only applicable to objects that can be considered to be black bodies. A black body is an object that absorbs all radiation incident upon it, and then it re-radiates all this energy. Our sun, for example, can be approximated as a black body that has a surface temperature of 5800 Kelvin. Using Wien's displacement law, let's work out its peak wavelength. Peak wavelength is equal to 2.898 times 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by 5800 Kelvin. That gives us 5.02 times 10 to the power of minus 7 meters, or we can say it's 502 nanometers. And that is green in the visible light spectrum. So our sun emits most visible light in the green region. But why doesn't it appear green to us? This is more to do with biology than physics. Our eyes have receptors for red, green, and blue colors. Even though the sun spectrum peaks at green, it also emits in the red and blue regions. Our eyes have not evolved to distinguish the color of highest intensity from colors of lower intensity. Our brain is going to mix all three colors together, forming white. Thanks for watching my video, and if you think you learned something from it, be sure to subscribe.